पूछो जाके उनसे जिन पे रोशनी नहीं, पूछो जाके उनसे कैसी लगती है कमी।
हेलो एवरीवन, myself Nikhat Shadab, I welcome you all to the OctoHub, a platform and growing. So in today's session, we guys will get to know about basics of OCT by Brajesh Kumar sir. He is presently working as faculty of optometry retinal department at Dr. Shroff Charity Eye Hospital, New Delhi. He is well versed in advanced posterior segment diagnostics and ophthalmic imaging, and also holds an experience. He himself is a masterpiece. We are keen to hear you, sir. Thank you so much for accepting our invitation. And you guys can join our Telegram group to know more about Nectra. So, sir, over to you now. Please continue.
Thank you so much. So, we will be going to discuss about how many. I want to have an interactive discussion. First of all, I would try to finish my presentation by 30 minutes, and then after questions if you are having for any queries. So today we will be discussing about OCT. I am involved as a faculty optometrist in retina department and involved as a optometrist for cosmetic procedures like OCT, FFA and other diagnostic techniques. So before starting my presentation, let me start with the introduction. You all have been students, and clinical examination starts from a history taking. History taking means whenever a patient is coming to your clinic, you need to ask for what reason he has come to your. Heard of the many type of complaints like patient has come to your clinic for with the reason of blurring of vision, itching, watering, redness. These are the several other complaints a patient might have for which he comes to your clinic. This can be, he can see up the eye. Whenever he's seeing in front, he see a black shadow or black spot in front of his eyes. Or whenever he's seeing at any face of a person or whenever he's seeing at any central portion of a book, it might get distorted or blurred. Similarly, he might see whenever he's seeing at a straight line, it might appears wavy, or the letters also seems disappearing. The letters just disappear from the book. So these are the some other complaints. Any guesses? Can anyone tell? Anyone?
Hello.
Yes.
So if the patient has any there in the retina part, then he will face all this difficulty.
Exactly. The patient is having any pathology in retina. If the patient is having, he might complain of such type of problems. So earlier, as we all know that optometrist role was limited to anterior part. We were doing history taking, vision, different. If a patient is coming with a complaint of blurring of vision, if we found cataract, we go for anterior segment diagnostic like biometry. If a patient is having the diagnostic procedures which are focused for the anterior part. But now optometrist has extended his role in diagnostics also. If a patient is coming with a retina problem, whenever an ophthalmologist and doctors examines the fundus, he just go for which is done by an optometrist, which confirms the diagnosis done by the doctor is correct or not. And in addition to that, the diagnosis made also needs to be monitored. So optometrist roles has been extended to posterior part also. So OCT, as today's topic, OCT is one of the important tool in retina diagnostic image. For a doctor making a diagnosis, it needs to be confirmed by our diagnostic procedures. Similarly, it also confirms and affirms that this diagnosis made by doctor is correct. And in follow-up visits, whenever a patient is coming to clinic and what condition he is having, it can be also confirmed by the OCT machines. So OCT is very important tool in retina diagnostic, which helps in finding any retinal pathology. So today I will be discussing machine OCT procedures. So I will start my presentation with what is OCT. Okay, then I will go for types. What are the different types of OCT available? Next, then what are the conditions we need to go for an OCT test? Then what procedures, how OCT can, different types of scans we need to capture during the retinal pathology? Again, how an OCT scan look like whenever we are working in a clinic. Patient, we have not seen patient. A patient just walks in with an OCT reports. Then what OCT reports look like? What does this mean? And what are the color, the green color, the black color, the blue color? What we will be discussing in that. We will not be discussing about the different pathology like the macular problems or other retinal pathology. That will be discussed in the interpretation part. We are just talking about day only. And then what are the limitations whenever we are performing an OCT procedure? What are the limitations, in which conditions we need to compromise with the OCT scan? We will be discussing in the chat box. First, starting with OCT, what does OCT means? It is comprising of three words, OCT. What O means? Exactly. Optical means use of light. In normal scans, we are using ultrasound. Like whenever we are going for, so it is known as optical. Then what is coherence? Coherence. Anyone? So again, coherence
means we are having two wave light, they are having same frequency, phase difference,
and this condition is very important to produce interference. As you have studied in physics, we have properties of light like reflection, refraction, interference and diffraction. So coherence source is important requisite for having an interference pattern. And the last one, what is T? T stands for tomography. Tomography is composed of two words, and graphy means graphical representation. So we are displaying a three-dimensional imaging of a tissue by using ultrasound graphy, in which this is coherence. You can see in the picture, two waves are going simultaneously. In the top picture, they are almost same, and in the second picture we are having a constant phase difference. So coherence in physics means two wave source are perfectly coherent and waveforms are identical. Like in the second picture, we can see the waves are traveling similarly, identically, and in the last picture we can see that the waves maintaining a constant phase difference. And coherence is very important requisite to have an interference pattern. Then what is interference? You all have heard in first semester geometrical optics, interference.
Overlapping of?
Two or more waves
to produce what will
intersecting of
the interference is defined by a simple one word, that is called superimposition. Two waves are overlapping over each other. Two waves are interfering means superimposing on each other. And interference pattern can, one is, we know that in waves we have two, we have certain terminologies, like you have heard of maxima, minima. Whenever the maxima coincides, produces higher wavelength, higher in amplitude. Like in the first picture, when the two waves are in phase, they interfere, they produce a higher wave, higher amplitude wave. That in the second picture, when the two waves are out of phase, that is, they are maintaining a phase difference of 180 degree, then we are producing destructive interference. So for constructive interference, we need to have a two waves in phase, and for destructive. So these are the basics of OCT, like coherent source, interference. These are the prerequisite which we are having in phenomenon in tomography. So just to start with, what is optical coherence tomography? We all know that optical coherence tomography is a non-contact procedure, like FFA is an invasive procedure. We can go directly to test the OCT and take our scan. And even in the follow-up visits, we can take scan and compare with the previous procedure. It is a diagnostic technique. As we have already told, that whenever a doctor is making a diagnostic, making coherence near infrared light. In place of ultrasound, this machine uses low coherence near infrared light. And it produces a high resolution of approximately 10 micron. And in even it can produce high resolution of even 2 to 3 mics of OCT, which are producing higher resolution than this also. This is normal resolution. It gets a resolution of approximately. Now, as we compare OCT with the standard imaging techniques, we all know that ultrasound. Everyone had heard of this ultrasound?
Yes, sir.
Ultrasound has. Yes, ultrasound. Whenever getting an infection in stomach, you need to go for ultrasound, many procedure. In that case, the resolution is much higher. But it is very less. For high resolution, we need to have a less penetration. The another procedure is confocal microscopy. In that case, the resolution is much better. It is not reached in the range of 10 micrometer or 5 micrometer or 3 micrometer, which is our biological tissue of human eye. So for that, we need an OCT in which we have less than 1 millimeter, that is 0.3 to 0.35 mm. And we are having a resolution of 1 to 15 micrometer. 1 to 15, that is in our detect for any pathology, any abnormality. Am I clear for this? Then yes. Next, we are going for OCT can be divided into two types. The one is Fourier domain OCT and another is time domain OCT. Domain OCT was earlier used in previous version more than 10 years back. Now at presently, we are using Fourier domain, that is known as spectral or even SS OCT, swept source OCT. Types. One is spectral luminosity and another is swept source. So we have the most popular OCT used in today's time is spectral luminosity, is basically based on spectrophotometer, while the swept source OCT is tunable laser based, means we have replaced the light source by a laser point so that it is producing. In spectral luminosity, it even captures the smallest wavelength that is returned. So am I clear with the types? We are having two types, and the most popular types is using is spectral luminosity we are using at present. Now moving into the next, if we differentiate between time luminosity, OCT was back. So time domain OCT means we are capturing one pixel at a time, sequential one pixel at a time. Simultaneously in Fourier domain, we are capturing simultaneously 1024 pixels. Means you can understand it is 1000 times faster than time domain OCT. That is times better in Fourier domain OCT as compared to time domain. Similarly, time domain OCT acquires 400 A scans per second. But Fourier domain city acquires 1000 to 4000 A scan per second. Means it is 100 times faster. 100 times faster can give a better quality of OCT scans, much better in retinal diagnosis. In time domain OCT, we have an axial resolution of greater than 10 micron OCT is 3 to 5 micron, which is the best resolution. Normally, we can get a resolution of 10 microns. In time domain OCT, the signal to noise light we are supplying to the machine and how much divergence disturbances. We are throwing any light source and getting a light back. Means we are throwing 100% light and we are getting 20% light. We are getting 70% has been noise, 30% has been disturbances. That is the signal to noise ratio. So in time domain OCT, it is high. But in Fourier domain OCT, seeing a high resolution image in case of Fourier domain OCT. So I'm showing a picture, just differentiate and you can feel that how the scan see the reverberation, the greenish, bluish is distorted. But in the second picture, you can clearly differentiate the different layers of the retina, RPE to the nerve fiber layer. We can clearly differentiate the different layers are stacked one above the other. So the resolution is much better in Fourier domain OCT as compared to the first domain.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Say that if a OCT machine has higher speed and higher definition and higher signal, that means which one OCT is?
Fourier.
OCT is the OCT with less speed, less definition, less resolution, and the OCT with high definition, high speed, and higher domain OCT, which we are using at present. So these are some of the OCT which we are available in the market. The Zeiss company has, which is incorporated with angiography, which has been, angiography is an invasive procedure. If we can make an alternative that we can find the blood flow with the OCT scans, it can replace angiography. It cannot completely replace angiography, but somehow at some extent it can give the information related to that angiography plex, which is incorporated with angiography features also. The next OCT is Heidelberg OCT, used for taking scans of retina. So now moving on to the principle of interferometry, I'm not going this video, and then we will interpret how interferometry means we are producing an interference pattern. If you are understanding this picture, you can clearly make out the principle of OCT. So just in this video, we have a beam splitter. The center mirror is this one, is the beam splitter. Is
yes, sir. It's visible.
Okay, this center is the beam splitter, which divides the light into two directions. Light is thrown to the another mirror. When both the light is reflected back, they are again collected back at the beam splitter to the detector plate. So we thrown a light to the beam splitter. It divides the light into two directions, one to the one mirror and the second to the another mirror. Again, the light is there at the beam splitter and then directed to the detector plate as in the picture. Just say this. Just noticed? If fusion of mirror, we can move the length, we can move the waves, height of the waves. Like, see this. If this is the wave produced, reflection collected at the beam splitter, then these two waves superimposes. then these two waves superimpose, and then now if we are moving the position of mirror, that the position of maxima and minima changes. When the maxima coincide light pattern, when the maxima coincided with minima, it gets a dark pattern. Just see at the screen. Then when the maxima meets with maxima, it is bright, and when maxima meets with dark pattern. So in this kind, we can find the interference pattern on the interferometry principle. I am again showing this. So the again photodetector plate produces interference pattern in the form of bright light and dark light as minima maxima coincide with minima.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now moving on to the principle of interferometry. Now again, same. This is the light source which is producing the light to the beam splitter that is known as coupler. Now this beam splitter divides the light into two directions. One light is directed to this mirror, that is reference mirror, and the other to the eye. This is our eye study of interest, in which we are capturing the scan for the retinal pathology. So we divided the light into two parts. One is directed, and the other light is directed to the human tissue or retinal tissue. Now again, the light is reflected back from the retinal tissue as well as the mirror. This light is ocular, and then it is directed to the detector plate. Then here it is processed, and as OCT scan image is displayed on the screen.
Yes, sir.
I am again explaining, this is the light source. This is throwing the light to the reference mirror, and the another light is directed to the human retinal tissue. Now again, both the light is reflected back from, again collected at this beam splitter, and then directed to the photodetector plate. Here photodetector plate processes the images, the reflected light, and then we get a image on the screen. A simplified picture of this OCT principle can be seen. Beam splitter going to one reference mirror, one to both light returning back, getting collected here, and then of OCT principle, this is, which is known as Michelson. Michelson was the science principle is based on Michelson interferometer principle. Am I clear for that?
Okay.
Now moving on to the next part. In what cases we need to go for an OCT scan? Can anyone tell what are the patients for the OCT scan, taking OCT scan?
RNFL, macula.
Degeneration.
Macular degeneration, anything else?
Any kind of morphological changes in retina?
Not for that.
CME.
Hello.
CME. So these are the some pathology like macula, CSR.
So retinal detachment
retinal detachment does not need OCT. management is surgical. If retinal detachment, for that we can go for OCT only when we have to need to look for macular status, whether it is macula off or on. Then we restore any macular pathology, we need to go for OCT scan, like macular hole, any macular edema, cystic, cystoid macular edema, diabetic macular edema, like age-related macular degeneration, ARMD. In case of glaucoma, like retinal nerve fiber loss, ganglion cell complex loss, like OCT, GCC is done in case of glaucoma, central serous retinopathy, then diabetic retinopathy, and even VMT or ERM. VMT is our tractional macular hole, and that can might lead to retinal detachment. So that tractional, that need to traction, for traction we need to go for OCT procedure. So these are certain cases. There are several other cases, like if we are having any drusens, for in case of ARMD or RP atrophy, even after for that also we need to go for OCT test. In high case of myopia, we have a retinal degeneration at macula, so you need to go for OCT. There are several other indication. Basically, you need to understand, for any macular pathology we need to go for an OCT scan to rule out whether the macula is thin, whether macula has been tractionally pulled out, which can lead to other. So can anyone tell other causes in which we can go for OCT test? This we can have a discussion.
BRVO, CRVO.
Exactly. In case of vein occlusion, if OCT test. And similarly, after once you have got injection, like in case of vein occlusion, if you are having any vascular, we are having any macular edema, then we have to compare. We have given any anti-VGF injection. Then after that, when the patient is coming for follow-up, we need to compare that scan, OCT test. After pre and post injection, pre and post anti-VGF injection, we need to go for OCT test. Anything else? VMT, DVD. We will be all discussing all the cases in the next class, in which we will be discussing about the interpretation of OCT and different cases. So it is, can we do ASOCT for anterior segment examination? Yes, exactly, we can do ASOCT for corneal thickness as well as anterior segment examination. We can do ASOCT to, in case of like cataract post-op patient, we desmoid membrane detachment. For that, we need to do for ASOCT. CNVM, in case of CNVM, we can go for OCT. Any other condition? For tachymetry also, we can do that. We can go for ASOCT for using multi-point tachymetry. RP basically goes for macular thinning. So it is a prerequisite. You can go for OCT as for comparison follow-up visits. Macular dystrophy, we can go for OCTs. Ganglion cell count, that is in glaucoma. Cone dystrophy, we can go for OCT. So OCT is clear to everyone, ki when to go for OCT. PFT, we can go for OCT. And even Stargardt's, we have macular degeneration, need to rule out, we can go for OCT. So OCT has a vast role in most of the diseases, retinal diseases. So we can go for OCT in all the macular pathology, even a small pathology, CSR or CSCR. Both are same thing. But to rule out the involvement of CSR in choroid, we need to go for OCT, whether it is the fluid is connecting to the choroid also or not. So OCT is very important diagnostic tool in wide variety of retinal diseases. So we have less than 1 minute left. We can leave the sac. In uveitis, not exactly in uveitis, we can go for OCT. Retinal dystrophy, yes, we can. uveitis can be associated with.
So guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you like it. So please don't forget to give it a big fat thumbs up. And to know more about it, you will have to watch the part 2. So which will be uploaded soon. Thank you so much once again. Please write the comments in the comment section how you like the video. Thank you so much.